Okay, so let's just start with the reason we want this in the first place. Number one, if you're not good at color and you struggle with it, you can grab images from photographs, paintings, your old paintings, anything that has good color, and you're going to use that, or you're going to take this color, we're going to put it in your swatch palette. So let me show you how this is done. Go up to filter, go down to pixelate. And we're going to go to Mosaic. Okay. With this slider, this window, you get to control the tolerance slider for how large the squares are going to be in terms of their size. The larger you go, obviously you're not going to have as many colors or variations of color. If you want to have more variations of color, you can slide it down and get it's going to be tinier squares, but you will have more colors. It's up to you which way you want to go. My preference is I like to have the square size is relatively large because this is just going to be used to give me a base palette, and I will also deviate by making little adjustments with my color wheel as well when I'm picking color. So let's go ahead and click OK. Next, we're going to go to Image Mode. Image mode, then you're going to go to index color. Okay, so right here, just click OK, leave it alone, everything's fine. Local, selective, 256, don't have to do anything. Click OK. Next, we're going to go back up into image mode, down to color table. Okay, with this dialog box, this is going to be the swatches that you're going to see transferred into your swatch palette. Okay. So at this point, you can leave it as is. You can hold down Command key, and if there are certain colors that you didn't want, so let's just say there's a bunch in here that are very similar. If you hold Command, you can actually delete many of these colors out. Okay. It's showing you a preview of the image up here, but that's irrelevant. We're not using that painting of the teddy bears for anything but its color. But what it's allowing me to see are the swatches that are going to be used. Now, let's say you make a mistake and you delete out, let's just say, a bunch of colors, and you're kind of freaked out. All you have to do is hold Option key, and up here you'll see Reset. It'll toggle on Reset. So usually it's Cancel. Now it's reset. Click on this, and it goes back to the base when you first opened it. You'll see inside of here there are other controls. You do not want to use these because it will alter your color. Okay. And what you'll notice when you go through each one of these, you're like, what happened to the color? Not usable. Then when you get back up here to custom, you lost your color. So again, if that happens, you hold down Option, hit reset. So I have my color swatches right here, ready to go. Now what I'm going to do is hit save. I'm going to go to the desktop to navigate. I'm going to call this teddy bear. Okay, and when you save your swatches, the file extension is going to be a .act. This is so when you're navigating looking for it, remember you're going to look for a .act. So hit save. Okay, go ahead and hit OK. We're out of here. Now, when we go over to your swatch palette, go to the pop-up menu or the pull-down menu. Click. We're going to go down and we're going to load swatches, or you can replace swatches. Actually, let's go ahead and do replace swatches so it's the only thing that's going to be available. So it's going to ask me, do I want to save the swatches that I have in here, the changes? I don't need to, so I'm going to hit don't save. Now I'm going to navigate to the desktop. Okay, so I'll see teddybear.act. Go ahead and select that. Click open. Now they're loaded inside here for you. Okay, so this is great because when you're working in full screen mode, and I'll go ahead and toggle over to this screen. Okay. When you're working in full screen mode, if you wanted to have your swatches or that other file in here, typically you can't have two images open in full screen mode. So by having it in the swatches, it's going to allow you to be able to access all those colors and just be ready to go. One other thing I'm going to show you though, okay, a little extra. Let's go back to this. If you did want to have this on a current document that you're painting on, if you select all, copy, or you could cut it, doesn't matter. Okay, and I'm going to toggle over to my other image. Then I'm going to paste. Now you're going to have the swatch palette with its squares located right here for you. So that way you can toggle it on and off. The benefit of having the swatches on the side is that you don't have a layer with an image on it that's obstructing your view of what you're painting. So keep that in mind, but everyone's going to have their preferences. Okay, I hope you like that one, and I hope that you're going to be able to make good use of it. So in the meantime, what I want you to do is just keep painting, having fun with this. And if you enjoyed the video, please don't hesitate to go down and hit the like and subscribe button. And until next time, I'll see you and keep painting.